Welcome to Grade 3 Mathematics Part 4 Video of Division.
Hello everyone. How are you all? I hope you all are safe and healthy. In previous session, you have learned how to divide. In this session, we are going to work out the story sums in division. The basic steps to remember are, we have to read and understand the statement sums and then use the correct operation to find out the answer. When to solve the word problem using division? If the word problem includes distribution or splitting. If we have information about all and being asked about one. Using keywords. Divide, split, distribute, cut up, half, average, packaging, shared equally, how many in each. Let us do classwork word problems. There are 880 books which are arranged in 8 shelves. Find the number of books in each shelf. Here in the question, what is given, children? 880 books are in 8 shelves. 8 shelves means many shelves. What we should find out, children? Number of books in each shelf. Each shelf means one shelf. Many they have given, one we are finding. Many to one we should do division operation. Now we will frame statements. 880 books means counting the number. First statement. Number of books in 8 shelves is equal to 880. Second statement. Number of books in each shelf is equal to 880 divided by 8. Now let us divide 880 divided by 8. Now compare highest place with the divisor. What is the highest place, children? Hundreds place. What is the digit in the hundreds place? 8. Compare 8 with the divisor 8. 8 is equal to 8. Here we see the table of 8 to find the product which is equal to and nearest to 8. As we know that 8 ones are 8, we write 1 in the quotient and 8 under hundreds place under 8 and subtract 8 from 8. 8 minus 8 is equal to 0. Now bring down the next digit, that is 8. So here we compare 8 with the divisor 8. 8 is equal to 8. Here in the 8th table, 8 ones are 8. We write 1 in the quotient and 8 under 8 and subtract 8 from 8. 8 minus 8 is equal to 0. Lastly, bring down the next digit, that is 0. Here in the 8th table, 8, we know that 8 zeros are 0. We write 0 in one's quotient and 0 under 0 and subtract. 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. As there are no more digits to bring down, the division is completed. Now let us write the final statement. Therefore, number of books in each shelf. Each shelf is equal to 110. Question number 2. The price of half dozen of chairs is rupees 2844. Find the price of one chair. Here in the question, what is given, children? Price of half dozen of chairs is rupees 2844. Price means cost. Cost of half dozen of chairs is rupees 2844. Children, what do you mean by half a dozen? Let me explain. Dozen means 12. Half dozen means half of 12. That is 6. So, price of 6 chairs is rupees 2844. What we should find out, children? Price of one chair.
Price means cost. Cost of one chair. Here they have given 6 chairs. We should find out one chair. Many they have given, one we are finding. Many to one we should do division operation. Now we will frame statements. First statement. Cost of half dozen of chairs. Half dozen of chairs means 6 chairs. Is rupees 2844. Second statement. Cost of one chair. 2844 divided by 6. Now let us divide 2844 divided by 6. We start comparing the digits of the dividend with the divisor. Also start checking from the highest place. Here the highest place is thousands place. The digit in the thousands place is 2 compared to with the divisor 6. 2 is lesser than 6. So we have to consider next hundreds place digit, that is 8. Now compare 28 with the divisor 6. 28 is greater than 6. And therefore we can divide 28 by 6. We use the table of 6 to find the product which is equal to and nearest to 28. 28 is nearest to 24 and 30. Since 30 is greater than 28, we cannot take 6 5s are 30. We have to take 6 4s are 24. We write 4 in the quotient. We write 24 under 28 and subtract. 24 from 28. 8 minus 4, 4. 2 minus 2, 0. Now compare 4 with the divisor 6. 4 is lesser than 6. So we have to consider the next tens place digit, that is 4. Now the number is 44. Now compare 44 with the divisor 6. 44 is greater than 6. And therefore we can divide 44 by 6. Again we use the table of 6 to find the product which is equal to and nearest to 44. 44 is nearest to 42 and 48. Since 48 is greater than 44, we cannot take 6 8s are 48. We have to take 6 7s are 42. We write 7 in the quotient and we write 42 under 44 and subtract. 42 from 44. 4 minus 2, 2. 4 minus 4, 0. Now compare 2 with the divisor 6. 2 is lesser than 6. So we have to consider next ones place digit, that is 4. Now the number is 24. Now compare 24 with the divisor 6. 24 is greater than 6. And therefore, we can divide 24 by 6. Again, we use the table of 6 to find the product which is equal to and nearest to 24. As we know that 6 4s are 24, we write 4 in the quotient and we write 24 under 24. And subtract 24 from 24. 24 minus 24 is 0. As there are no more digits to bring down, the division is completed. Now let us write the final statement. Cost of one chair is equal to rupees 474. Question number 3. A train travels a distance of 1296 kilometers in 8 hours. How far the train travels in an hour? Here in the question, what is given, children? A train travels a distance of 1296 kilometers in 8 hours. In 8 hours, the train is traveling 1296 kilometers. What we should find out, children? How far the train travels in AR? In AR means in 1 hour. So 8 hours, many hours they have given, 1 we are finding. Many to 1 we should do division operation. Now let us frame statements. 1296 kilometers means distance traveled. First statement, distance traveled by a train in 8 hours is equal to 1296 kilometers. Second statement, distance traveled by a train in 1 hour is equal to 1296 divided by 8. Now let us divide 1296 divided by 8. We start comparing the digits of the dividend with the divisor 8. Also start checking from the highest place. Here the highest place is thousands place. The digit in the thousands place is 1. Compare 1 with the divisor 8. 1 is smaller than, lesser than 8. So we have to consider the next hundreds place digit, that is 2. Now compare 12 with the divisor 8. 12 is greater than 8. And therefore we can divide 12 by 8. We use the table of 8 to find the product which is equal to and nearest to 12. 12 is nearest to 8 and 16. As 16 is greater than 12, we cannot take 8 twos are 16. We have to take 8 ones are 8. We write 1 in the quotient and we write 8 under 12 and subtract 8 from 12. 2 minus 8. 2 is smaller than 8. Borrow from before number. Cut 2 and write 12. Cut 1 and write 0. 12 minus 8 is 4. Now compare 4 with the divisor 8. 4 is lesser than 8. So we have to consider the next tens place digit, that is 9. Now the number is 49. Now compare 49 with the divisor 8. 49 is greater than 8. And therefore we can divide 49 by 8. Again we use the table of 8 to find the product which is equal to and nearest to 49. 49 is nearest to 48 and 56. As 56 is greater than 49, we cannot take 8 sevens are 56. We have to take 8 sixes are 48. We write 6 in the quotient and we write 48 under 49 and subtract. 48 from 49. 9 minus 8, 1. 4 minus 4, 0. The difference is 1. 1 is smaller than 8. So we have to consider the next ones place digit, that is 6. Now the number is 16. Now compare 16 with the divisor 8. 16 is greater than 8. And therefore we can divide 16 by 8. Again we use the table of 8 to find the product which is equal to and nearest to 16. As we know that 8 twos are 16, we write 2 in the quotient and we write 16 under 16 and subtract 16 minus 16. 16 minus 16 is equal to 0. As there are no more digits to bring down, the division is completed. Now let us write the final statement. Therefore, distance traveled by a train in 1 hour is equal to 162.
Thank you, children. Have a cheerful day.